السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Dear student of third secondary, we are going to start chapter 5, organic chemistry. We will start the big part of our curriculum. I hope you enjoy this part. I think we have a lot of questions, but I think we need to be concentrated without this part. Let's discuss and we are going to illustrate every point in this chapter. Let's start. Okay, at first we are going to make introduction for our part of the meaning of word organic chemistry. What is the meaning of organic chemistry? It is the study of carbon compounds. What is the meaning of the study of carbon compounds? That means that we have living sources around us, like plants and animals. They are living organisms, and we can take every part or every living cell from plants and animals. That we can take compound from these living organisms, we can call them what? Organic compounds. So in 18th century, chemists thought that everything or organic compounds can be obtained only from living sources as plants and animals. But Fritz Wöhler, German scientist, you know that we can say W as a V in a German language, succeed to prepare the first organic compound. We called it urea. Urea, it is the first organic compound that obtained from source of inorganic substance. We have two substances here, lead cyanate and ammonia. This is the first organic compound, urea, obtained from inorganic compound. So at the first question here that we obtained, we can get organic compound from inorganic one. Yes, this is the right question. Okay, what is the first organic compound that scientist or chemist can make or made? We have here urea. It is the first compound or the first organic compound that obtained from inorganic compounds. Okay, we have here natural and synthetic organic compound. We have more than or over 14 million synthetic organic compounds, comparing with the inorganic. Inorganic, we have 100,000 inorganic compound, but in case of organic or natural and synthetic at all organic, we have more than or over 14 million compounds. Okay, this is introduction for our name of chapter, organic. Okay, let's continue. What about this periodic table? We have common elements that we use in organic compounds. We use group 3A in the long periodic table, 3A, 4A, 5A, 6A, and 7A. The compounds or the element that we use to obtain the organic compound, we have boron in group 3A that ends with 3 electron, and carbon, it is the main compound or main element of our compounds, silicon, nitrogen, phosphorus, oxygen, sulfur, fluorine, chlorine, bromine, iodine, all the group of 7A, they are the natural element that we take, and the main of our hydrogen, of our gases, hydrogen. Most of our organic elements here belong to nonmetals. So we have here most of them in cases of gases state. Okay, we have some of them solid and some of them liquid, like bromine, and we have most of them in the case of gases state. Okay, let's continue. Carbon can form millions of different compounds. Why? Okay, we have here We can make single or double or treble with many chains and can make a ring structure also. So why we use or why we obtain million of different compounds? Because carbon can make not only a single bond, it can make double bond and a triple bond with many elements and chains and ring structure. Okay, we classify or classes of organic compounds according to the functional group they contain. Okay, we have the functional group. It means that a group of atoms that largely responsible for the chemical behavior for what? For the parent molecule, or giving the structure or giving the character for the parent molecule or the main part of the compound in front of us. Hydrocarbons mainly consist of hydro means what? Mean coming from hydrogen here, and carbon come from the atom or element carbon. So hydrocarbons made up mainly of two elements, carbon and hydrogen. Okay, we can classify hydrocarbons into main structure or main parts. We have aliphatic and aromatic. What is the meaning of each of them? We will discuss as all. Aliphatic means it is a symbol and may form simple compound like alkanes, cycloalkanes, alkenes, and alkynes. We will discuss each one in details in our parts, okay? So hydrocarbons classified into aliphatic and aromatic, okay?